Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make this beginner project tutorial as a portion models. Let's go to the video. First, as you see, our interface is look like this in the Blender. We will add something on here. If you want, you can go from the top add button or with the Shift A, you can add some mesh onto your scene. We will add some UV sphere in here. With the numpad 1, you can look your objects from the front view, numpad 3, side view, and numpad 7, top view. We will use them, you can see, from the left bottom our screencast. When you press G, you can move your sphere. Press G, Z, and 1. After all of that, if you want, you can change this edit mode from the top left, or with the pressing tab, you can switch your object mode and edit mode. Now we are in the vertex select. You can move some vertices and give a shape onto your meshes like this. We will use this type of methods too much. Choose your bottom vertex, and after that, from the top, you can click in here from the proportional editing. When you try to G to move some of your vertices, as you see as a circle, with the mouse wheel, you can increase and decrease. For this proportional edit, you can press O for the shortcut key. Now we will give a shape with our proportional edit. You can G to move and press Z to lock your axis. You can give a shape for your bottle. Again, in the keyboard, 1 is vertex select, 2 edge select, and 3 face select mode. When you choose your faces with the Alt, it will select all your face line. And after you choosing, press X and delete these faces. For the edge selection mode, you can press 2, choose this bottom edge line with Alt, and after that, close your proportional edit, E to extrude this edge line in the Z axis. Now, again, when it's selected, press E, right click, and S to scale. Again, we will E to extrude it down. In Z axis, you can lock it after you press E and Z, and F to fill for the bottom part. In the object mode, you can right click shade smooth, and under the data, under the normals, you can check your auto smooth. If it's not suitable for you this shape, when you want, you can choose these face lines with the Alt and S to scale for giving a new shape of your mesh. And now, with the proportional edit again, you can choose some face line and G to move in Z axis, don't forget to lock it, give some shape. The top face line, you can choose with the Alt, and for the others, you can press Shift, X to delete these faces. Choose this edge line again with the Alt, and scale a bit with the proportional editing help. Close this proportional edit and E to extrude it up in Z axis with locking your axis. Now you can again E to extrude, right click and S to scale, and E to extrude this edge line to the bottom. It will look like this. Choose this edge line again. You can scale with S. With the adding new loop cut with Ctrl R, after that you can move it to the top. Choose this face line and E to extrude. As you see, right click and S to scale it. You can give a shape top of your bottle. With the toggle X-ray or the wireframe, with pressing Z as the shortcut key, you can choose some faces, front and backs easily. You can use this wireframe method for choosing some faces or vertices from front and back of your mesh. After you choose this, Shift D to duplicate it, right click, and press P, separate selection. As you see, there are two different separated objects in your scene. For the middle of it, we will scale a bit because we will make this part to the liquid. As you see, in the toggle X-ray, it will look like this. You can choose this edge line again and F to fill. We will use this later with the giving some material. Turn back to the solid view. When you want, you can choose this inner face line, shift it to duplicate it, and press Z, move it to the top, and press P, selection. But its effect to the main model. For this, you can right-click, set origin, and origin to geometry. After that, you can scale your base origin from your top part. You can choose some edge line and G to move them. For the top of it, scale and move it to the down. For this edge line, you can press F to fill. With the loop cut, Ctrl R, you can add a loop cut and move it top. Choose this face line with Alt and E to extrude, right click and S to scale again. When you want, you can choose some of edges or faces. You can give some scale in locking some axis or give different shape, more wider or more thinner. For this bottle, I will add some modifier. Go to Modifier tab and choose Bevel. When you choose your bevel, it will give smoothness to your edges. With the increase in your segments, as you see, it came out looking good. For the top part, I will add bevel modifier it too. You can increase your segments and give some smoothness to your edges. After that, you can apply your modifier. Choose all of them. With the box selection, press M, and as a new collection, you can give a name and press OK. Let's add some mesh, circle. We will make some rope for this. I will show you an easy method to you. Shift it to duplicate it, press X and 1. And shift it to duplicate it again, press Y and 1. And G to move this top circle, press X, negative 0.5. After that, choose all of them and Ctrl J to join them together. Choose these middle vertices. Press X and delete vertices. As you see, there are two types of those vertices in here. Press M and merge them at center when you choose them too with the shift. Choose all with A and right-click smooth your vertices. In object mode, don't forget to right-click set origin, origin to geometry. You can scale it a bit. And under the modifier, choose screw modifier. With the screw value, as you see, it will look like a rope now. Press Shift S and selection to cursor. And you can scale in Z axis too. Now we have to add something. With the Shift A under the curve, you can choose this curve circle. Scale and place it where you want. Choose the screwed mesh and add modifier again as a curve modifier. As the curve object, choose this Bezier curve circle. But it's not looking true way. You can change your deform axis, negative Z. You can increase your iteration and change your screw value for connect them together. It will look like this. With the Shift D, you can G to move it a bit and scale. Change your screw value and connect them together. Apply your screw and curve modifier. Set origin to geometry and scale a bit. Your rope and bottle will look like this. Now let's add some material. Go to Shading tab. Under the world settings. First we have to delete this light, the X. From the polyhaven, if you want, you can add some studio lights, HDRI, from here. These are totally free HDRIs, textures and models. If you want, you can download something from the indoor or skies type of the HDRIs. I downloaded this Photo Studio Loft Hall as a 2K. After you download it, under the Shading tab, press Shift A and type Environment Texture. connect your color to background color, and open up your HDRI map. As you see, it came in here, it will affect like this. But we want only light effect, so under the render settings, under the film, check transparent. As you see, background become transparent. Turn back to the object mode. Choose your model. After that, press this new button. From the right menu, you can add your new material from here too. Type your model. And after that, there are two types for making glass material. First, under the principle BSDF, let's try something. Increase your transmission to 1 and decrease your roughness value. As you see, it affects your glass. The other method, delete your principle BSDF with the del button. After that, you can add some glass BSDF with the Shift A. After that, connect this BSDF to the material output surface. As you see, it affects your glass material in here too. For the inner parts, we will choose same material. From here, choose your bottle material, but it looks like a bit of water, so we have to change it. But how? First, in here, as you see, there is a new material button. When you press it, it will separate your new material. It's not affect to your main bottle material. From here, for your new liquid material, you can change your color inner of your liquid. It will not affect to your bottle material. Which color you want, you can make it. Let's turn back to the main method. Add again a principle BSDF. You don't have to make it if you want. Connect your BSDF and after that increase your transmission 1, decrease your roughness. It will affect like this. And now let's add some plane with Shift A and make a studio for ourselves. Turn back to the layout, go to render it view. It will look like this. You can change your plane material with the adding new material. As you see, when you press numpad 0, you can go to the camera angle. Under the view, navigation and walk navigation, you can move your camera with the WASD. But as you see, I have a quick favorite in here. Under the navigation and right click onto it and add to quick favorites. When you press Q, you can use your walk navigation easily. I am setting it like this and it's really easy to move your camera with the walk navigation. For the bottle, we will add some solidify modifier. Now, it's becoming correct. You can change your thickness from here, but don't make it too much. After we add some solidify modifier, it will look like this. Now, let's add some area lights for making some shiny of your water and bottle. With the adding area light, from the right menu, you can change your color and power values. You can rotate your camera in X-axis, G to move them in Z-axis, and place your lights where you want. From the top view with the numpad 7, you can shift it to duplicate your area lights. Let's make some this part of your materials. Now we will press again new material for the top. Let's add some Voronoi texture with Shift A and add some color ramp. Connect your color to color ramp's pack and color ramp's color to the principal BSDF base color. Now, as you see, it affects like the different shapes on it. With the changing your scale, you can set with the Voronoi texture's value. But we have to change our color. From the color ramp's black node and white node, you can slide them. For the white part, choose a color for yourself. I made it this type of orangey color and brownish. For the other, get your picker, get your same color and make it a bit darker. It will affect like this. If you want Voronoi texture distance, you can connect it to the color ramp's pack. It will affect this type of little dots. Let's add some bump note with the Shift A. And after that, connect your color to the height and bump note normal to the principled normal. It will affect this type of bumpiness look. With the bump note strength, you can change it and affect less. If you didn't like it, you can change it again your Voronoi texture's distance to the color. I like this and I will leave it like this. For the ropes, I am using same top material in here too. As you see, our bottle almost ready. For the glass BSDF, you can make it a bit darker for your bottle material. For the back plane, if you want to make some studio type, you can E to extrude this bottom edge, Ctrl B to bevel this middle edge line and right click shade smooth. You can increase your roughness value for not getting some reflect. Now you can H to hide all of them. Shift it to duplicate your bottle and lock in X axis. Alt H to unhide everything. Choose this other liquid, press new material button. Now you can change your new liquid material color. It will not affect your first liquid material. I like this type of look. You can move them down a bit. These bottles will look like this. And when you want, how you want, change your area lights, colors and powers. I am making this type health and mana pots. After you set up all the lights, you can go to the output settings and increase your resolution. Under the render settings, under the color management, you can change your look to high contrast. It will affect really shiny and good like this. And now go from the top render image. As you see, it will be rendered like this. It looks really realistic and funny. If you want to change your bottle's direction, you can move them with the front view, rotate and scale. How you want, you can set up your studio like this. Again, you can get some render image. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.